at this moment. I'm going to tie up a new leader. This is an old one from the last fishing trip I procrastinated, but I want to show that it can be done while in thigh-high water. If you got everything ready, it should be no problem. Check the rod, no matter what the length, underneath the arm. Cut off the leader, right at the nut. Starting with the offering, up and around your fingers. And then tuck it away for, well, hopefully later on, recycling. That's my recycle pocket for leaders. Now I'm going to retie. Since this is a different system, I'm going to retie with a double rig setup. And these are Chinook. So I'm going to use a bright orange, Porky, and yarn. Got to tie it around this nice. Plumbing tool, tubing. You can get them just about any hardware store. Now, you see the line is kind of springy. I'm going to get that line out, or that spring out, by grabbing the hook by the eye. I'm going to take the main line, or the leader, pardon me, and thread it between the thumb and the forefinger. Now I'm going to wrap it around with the index finger, and I'm going to pull slightly hard. Not too hard, but slightly enough. It'll take the spring out. And look at that. That increases line sensitivity, which is really important to... When fish are pressured. This system's being worked on by the Department of Transportation and Puget Sound Power. I believe that's Puget Sound Power. You never know. I mean, there's so many dams nowadays. I could be in the wrong area entirely. Now I'm going to tie a clinch knot. It's a double clinch knot, also called an improved clinch knot. I wrap the tag end 6 times, and just before I clinch or tighten it up, I get the knot a little bit wet. It does 2 things. It cuts down on heat and makes the knot really, really tight. So I cut the tag end so that there's maybe a 1/4 inch of extra line for play, but only after I'm absolutely sure the line is taut. Then I make sure that any yarn is not going below the bend. Before I cast out, I'm going to put on a little bit of scent. It does 2 things. This is a shrimp scent. It gets rid of my odor, and it's something these fish are accustomed to biting into. And I'm ready to go. Fish on. Oh, there's one more thing I should have done. I need to... This is a faster system than the last one I was on, so I'm going to replace my slinky weight, which is light. It's got a 4-shot Magnum slinky, which I make myself. I should also say that you can get plumbing insulation to hold your leaders. Just about any hardware store on earth, just about any hardware store will have it. They never come to the water. Fresh water. Without having pre-made slinkies in advance. These are kind of heavy. It's about one ounce. Not as heavy as fishing bigger, faster water, you know, like maybe the Columbia River or the Fraser River. Those are pretty big systems. This is a double rig swivel setup. This double rig swivel setup allows my leader and main line to stay distinctly separate from each other so that no twisting of the main line or the leader happens. That means I can fish longer. Okay. Now we'll give it a shot. For the weight purposes, this is going to be a double fist shot by the cast. Really excellent distance. I mean, with a little practice, you get to be a pretty good shot fishing seams. And there you have it. With the setup that I've got rigged right now, I could fish for hours. I shouldn't get snagged at all. And this place is just choking with gravel, boulders, rocks, all sorts of good stuff.